Blown Vegas, baby. Follow along as three award-winning World Series of Glass artists take a road trip for the first ever Glass Vegas Expo Smoke Shop of the Year party. We begin our adventure in a cramped camper along a perilous route headed north through Yellowstone for the sole purpose of throwing down some super sweet rigs blown live out front of the Montana Smokin Smittys Smoke Shop. Prepare yourself for the journey to the party to end all parking lot parties. This is Blown Vegas.
I love Glass Vegas.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've arrived. We're officially at Nectar Collector.
Let's go check this place out, huh?
What's up, what's up, what's up?
I'm looking forward to going today to Christian Merwin's and showing everybody what we've been working on. This last week, him and I have set out on an endeavor to make something that really hasn't ever been made before.
Hey, I'm Christian. I'm the inventor of the Nectar Collector. I designed it back in 2011. I've gone back to kind of doing my thing and trying to make more art and, you know, continue the evolution of the idea. Here's one of the newest versions, so you can see kind of the modular stuff. This comes out, you can take the diffuser out. So, you know, staying ahead of the game for sure. You know, making it so you can have, you can start out with some simple pieces and keep adding on to them and create your own custom heady piece.
I'm gonna dip this and blow a bubble for you guys.
Scientific glass factory that he buys to pour in there that makes that clear glass. And some of the things he's made have been crystal clear. Like, I've been surprised at the quality from the cullet. He's scraping some bad glass off the top that has bubbles and impurities from the crucible. That way, the next time when he actually dips, he gets right into clean, clear glass.
Dragon's egg that we dipped the other day. So we've got a little bit to learn on this. Got a little bit of air trapped in there, and I didn't go back and really like flame polish it out so the red really shows good, but it's got a lot of potential, and I think that we'll definitely be
keep going.
We'll be doing this on the next round for sure.
This is Slave Dragon number 7. I haven't named him yet. Some of them I've given names. This is the most recent one that I've just finished, yeah. So it's a color seriously, which is purple in this light right now. It's got two faceted elements. And it's the first time that I've done one of these where it wasn't just a short, straight tail. It was a lot harder for me to make this larger tail that curls all the way around at the front of the piece. So, and again, this is a recycler. There's the uptake right there, and then on the back is the two drains. So I'll be taking this to Smokin' Smittys with us to show off in Bozeman. So
then the head will go like this, and then you got a little rig, and then you can take this collar and this part and the head, and this will be a Nectar Collector here.
Yep, and put so a Nectar Collector tip at the
tip
bottom.
On it there.
So
that'll be pretty cool.
Yeah. And then this here as well.
I was looking at this, we can make
possibly
this into a Sherlock.
Oh yeah, that would
we
be dope.
You know, just have a bowl that
have a bowl that,
like a bowl that
there
clicks on there. So,
yeah.
Or even like
there's some Transformer shit right there.
Hey, this has never been seen.
So we don't even know everything it's going to be yet.
Yeah, we're
still, you know,
pioneering new territory.
We'll be making accessories for this for the next 6 months, I'm sure.
Well, I really can't fucking remember what we're doing, so it's like, I'm down for whatever. Like, I got enough weed that I don't give a shit what we do.
Are you tagging the camper?
Shit, no. I'm decorating. Yeah, I'm upgrading it.
Bueller.
Bueller.
It's like uranium-235. It's like a little, like, it's an isotope of uranium. And so it's like 0.01% uranium that's in our glass now.
Sure.
That's the same amount of exposure as you get by being around a smoke alarm for 30 minutes. It's the same amount of exposure if you went to the top of a mountain and stood there for an hour, because mountains put off radiation too. Glass workers to do this for 20 years, all of the tests and studies that we've done, like glass will trap radiation. We can use glass to trap radiation. So when this uranium is trapped in the glass, it's safe. When we start doing stuff like melting it, cold working it, using frit, blowing into it when it's 2,000 degrees, that has not been studied. That's a whole nother ball game. And that's where I think that it's not safe for glass workers for 20 or 30 years to use Illuminati in all these different forms and do all this different shit to it. So it's been bench tested, meaning it's been tested cold. If you cold work it, you got to wear a respirator, you got to wear clothes that are only for it, and you got to decontaminate yourself before going home to your family, because you release those radiation components. It's not trapped in the glassy matrix anymore. You've now separated the chemical elements. Working it with frits and powders would also be like highly not recommended. Yeah. So I think we're doing a big experiment, and we're gonna see what happens over 20 years.
We're at the entrance to West Yellowstone National Park. We're about to go through these beautiful trees and beautiful mountains.
I would like, if I may, to take you on a strange journey. It was a night out they were going to remember for a very long time.
Okay, hold on 1 second. Where the fuck else are we going?
There's no other way.
There's literally the only way to go is to go all the way back.
If you had to go back, you would go back to here, and you would take this road.
I'm fucking going through, dude. Look.
Hey, just go slow.
You know what? Cheese, I fucking love you. Good call. Go slow. Here we go, bitches.
It says
what else are we gonna do? We're gonna try to go 4 hours in the other direction?
Have to go 4 hours back, but you may have to go on a very roundabout easterly loop.
It says road work. I don't know.
You said easterly.
It said
easterly. Thank you for noticing. I carefully tried to get that out properly because I wasn't even sure it was right.
I had no idea.
Teddy, what are we doing?
So we are going around. We got to cut back this way.
Oh boy, you'll lose your life down there.
We in Yosemite in the middle of nowhere.
All right,
Taste Buddy Cartel Rebellion 9. You already know what it is.
Rebellion. The boys in the hood are always hot. Got track of the times, we'll call your car. Knowing nothing in life but to be legit. Don't pull me, boy, cause I ain't saying shit.
Playing your fucking car right now.
Did you see me?
Dude, what the fuck? Right Someone here. Takes a shit They're in our really fucking fun. Toilet and it's coming out the bottom.
Wasn't me.
Picked
it
up.
Wasn't me.
I didn't poopy in the bathroom. It wasn't me.
I didn't do it.
We're here with TT, man. We had Look, a slight,
we had a slight shit issue.
No.
Some motherfucker shit, and then some motherfucker overflowed it. I'm not gonna say his name.
There was nobody
Look,
took
I'm
a shit
Look, I'm not hiccuping.
This fucking motorhome's toilet is not proper.
I think Hick Dog fucked up the bathroom.
The septic on the RV is overflowing. The water that we have for the RV has all now been pumped into the septic to cause it to overflow because the toilet stuck open, so.
Bullshit! Oh. Next time on Blown.Vegas.
It's the Bear Negro! Oh, damn, it's bubbling hot out here in Yellowstone National Park. Boo-boos grabbing picnic baskets. Yogis hanging out with Ranger Dick. It's going down.
Oh my God, look at that thing. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a squirter.